1 million jobs gone. And that was just March, the COVID-19 economic fallout across the country.
We haven't seen a month-to-month decline like this since we've been collecting the modern statistics.
National pandemic projections released for the first time.
If our best efforts are successful, then possibly, hopefully, the first wave will end by the summer.
And a long weekend reminder not to give in to the urge to gather.
This weekend and the weeks ahead will be a difficult test for all of us.
Cloudy and warm today, but there's a cooling trend coming for Friday and the weekend with a high below zero on Saturday.
CTV Edmonton, local breaking news with Aaron Isfeld.
Good evening. For the first time, we are getting a glimpse at how a COVID-19 pandemic has impacted employment in our country. Experts are calling the latest job numbers unprecedented, and they say the situation is going to get worse before it gets better.
This is CBC Edmonton News.
Hi, it's nice to have you with us tonight. I'm Nancy Carlson, and we begin in Strathcona County, where the RCMP says a family of three has died in an apparent murder-suicide.
Madame, Monsieur, bonjour, ici Jean-Emmanuel Fortier. Bienvenue au Téléjournal Alberta. Voici ce qui retient l'attention chez nous aujourd'hui. Le gouvernement provincial renforce ses contrôles aux aéroports internationaux d'Edmonton et de Calgary pour les passagers à leur retour. On vous dit aussi pourquoi la Ligue nationale de hockey envisagerait la place Rogers d'Edmonton pour relancer la saison. Et puis on se penche sur les inquiétudes des propriétaires de gym en Alberta qui attendent impatiemment leur réouverture. Bonne fête, Madame, Monsieur. Eh bien, autre journée, autre bilan. Un bilan assez positif du coronavirus aujourd'hui. Il y a moins de 1000 personnes porteuses de la COVID-19 en Alberta. 1000 cas actifs. On n'avait pas vu ça depuis la mi-avril. Et ça, c'est la bonne nouvelle que nous rapporte mon collègue Laurent Pirot ce soir. Laurent, on voit une amélioration, y compris dans la zone plutôt chaude de Calgary.
It's Saturday, March 14th, and you're looking live at Rogers Place from our Global One News helicopter. The Oilers have just announced help for staff suddenly unable to work, with the NHL season suspended. More on that ahead. Plot.
Tonight on Global News Hour at 6.
We will be posting the flight information. Flight or portion of a flight where passengers may have been exposed to COVID-19.
Edmonton rec centers are closed, and there are new warnings to travelers as Canadians abroad are told to come home.
I joined Edmonton Police Service Class 57 on November 26, 1979.
A special honor is unveiled for some of Edmonton's policing pioneers. And dig in, Edmontonians mark Pie Day in the most delicious way.
You're watching Global Edmonton. This is Global News Hour at 6.
Good evening. Just minutes ago, all city-operated rec centers closed, including pools and the zoo, due to COVID-19 concerns. Earlier today, the federal government issued a warning to any Canadians abroad to come home. And here in Alberta, the number of confirmed COVID-19 cases has grown by 10 to 39.
No, I'm not too happy about it, especially considering what I drive.
The new year is finally here, and that means the federal carbon tax has been implemented here in Alberta. City News has more on this and the other new tax laws taking effect January 1st.
She's a pooping machine.
Yeah. Yeah. A poop factory.
A new year means New Year's Day babies ahead. Meet the first baby born in Edmonton this year.
Continuing the climate conversation, as one year comes to an end, we take a look back at the massive movement to stop rising temperatures. And also, we are looking ahead to what it will take for Canada to become a leader in the global fight against climate change.
Good evening and welcome to City News Edmonton at 6. We are here live in the River Valley on a beautiful New Year's Day, and a happy New Year's to everybody joining us tonight. Now today, a number of new laws came into effect across the country, but perhaps the biggest one here in Edmonton was the implementation of the federal carbon tax. But was the increase noticeable? Cheryl Tasaski finds out.